Good morning, friends. Now we are discussing simplex method with more than two variables. In the earlier problems, we have taken two variables. Now we have three variables here, and we have one non-linear constraint here. So having a negative value on the right-hand side. So now we'll see how to proceed. So as we said, so one of the constraint, that is the third constraint in the given problem, so that is having minus 3, so it is not a linear expression. So the given problem is not in the standard form. So for to make it into the standard form, so multiplying the problem, that is that particular constraint with minus 1 to get so we have minus x1, then minus x2, then this becomes plus x3, and greater than or equal to constraint become less than or equal to constraint now. So that is minus 3 becomes plus 3 on the right hand side. Now adding the slack variables and rewriting the objective function. So the objective function is this z is equal to, we have 6x1 minus 8x2 plus x3. So take all these terms to the left side. So we have 0 on the right hand side. Then we have here less than or equal to, less than or equal to. Anyway, this third constraint is also made into less than or equal to. So all the constraints are now less than or equal to. That means whatever we have on the left hand side is less than right hand side. That means something should be added here on the left hand side to make it equal to the right hand side. So in that connection, so we are adding the slack variables into these three constraints. So the slack variables are written here, s1, s2, s3, and the objective function is also rewritten like this. Now we'll have x1, x2, x3, that is the variables given in the problem, and the slack variables introduced, s1, s2, s3. So all of these are greater than or equal to 0. In no case these variables will take the negative values. Initially we will take s1, s2, s3 as the basic variables. Later any one of these variables or two or all these may enter into the given LPP. So we'll see which is entering and which is the living variable. So now we have written the first initial simplex table. So with the variables x1, x2, x3, then s1, s2, s3, then the objective function z. So the first three constraints are written in the first three rows. So that is this, with the coefficients 3, 1, 0 and 1. So that is what we have written, 3, 1, 0, 1. So we don't have s2, s3 in the first constraint. So made it to 0. We don't have z also there. So make it equal to 0. The solution is 10. So that is what written here. So then I will in the second equation, we'll have this x1, x2, and we don't have x3. So we have S2. So x3 and S1 having the coordinates 0, and S3 is also having the coordinate 0. So the solution is 5. So that is what is written for the row having the variable S2. Then in the third constraint, we have here minus 1, minus 1 and 1. Minus 1, minus 1 and 1. We don't have S1 and S2. We have S3, writing 1 as its coefficient. So we don't have Z. So writing 0, and its solution is 3. So that is what it is written in the table. Then we'll have the objective row with the coefficients as minus 6, 8 and minus 1. minus 6, 8 and minus 1. We don't have s1, s2, s3 and z value. So that is its coefficient is 1 here. We are writing it and solution is 0. That is also written here. So the initial simplex table is written here. Now in the objective function row, we have to see the most negative one. So that is minus 6 here out of this. So the most negative one is this. So taking this as the pivotal column now. So now x1 is the entering variable. Now we have to search for the corresponding pivotal row. For that we are finding the ratios. So the ratios will be found out like this. So the solution are there now. So divide the solution by this the entries in the pivotal column. So we have 10 divided by 3, so that is 3.33. so then 5 divided by 4, so that is 1.25 here. So and then this is we are getting 3 divided by minus 1, so that is negative value we don't consider. We want only the positive ratios here. So you take the lesser of these two ratios what we are getting, so that is 1.25. you make it as the pivotal row. Now where the pivotal column and pivotal row are intersecting, so that is the pivotal element. So in the next iteration, what has to be done is, so this pivotal element 4 should be made as 1, and other entries in the pivotal column, that is 3, minus 1 and 6, to be made 0 here. So that is what explained here. So the most take the most negative entry, so that is minus 6, so that is here. That is you take this as the pivotal column, and out of the ratios what is listed here, take the least positive ratio and that make that particular row as the pivotal row. So then we have the pivotal element, so that is 4 here, so that should be made 1. So for that we have to divide this particular row by entire row by 1, so that 4 divided by 4 it becomes 1. That pivotal element is made 1. So the other elements, the other entries are also divided by 4 here, so minus 1 divided by 4, so that is minus 1 by 4. Then here we have 0. 0 divided by anything is 0. Once again, 0 divided by anything is 0. Here I have 1 divided by 4. So that is what we have written here. And outside that table, we have the solution as 5. So that 5 is also divided by 4 here. So 5 is divided by 4 here. So first we are making the row change here. So that is the row number 2 is changed here. Right? So that is dividing by 4. That particular row is divided by 4, so that the row number 2 is changed here. And as we know, the other entries like 3, minus 1 and minus 6 to be made 0. For that we are doing the row operations here. So that are given here. So if we do this row operations, the entries here, so that is this, this and this, these entries will be made 0. Now, so this is the next iteration table what we obtained. So once again you are taking here the objective function row. If we have all these entries non-negative, then we can stop here and we can take this as the optimal solution table. But still we have negative values here in the objective function row. So the most negative one, anyhow we have only one negative value here, so we may make that particular column as the the pivotal column. Once the pivotal column is obtained, so in the solution column you take the ratios here. So divide 25 by 4 by 0, so it is infinity. So 5 by 4 divided by 0, also it is infinity. So then 17 by 4 divided by 1, so that is 4.25. anyhow, out of these three rows we have the ratio only here. If you have more than one of this ratios in all the three rows, you take the least positive value. Anyhow, we have only one ratio in these three rows. We'll take this particular row itself as the pivotal row, where the pivotal row and pivotal column intersect, so that it will be the pivotal element. So the next iteration table will be obtained by making this pivotal element as 1 by doing some row operation. But anyway, we have already one as the pivotal element, so we need not modify this row. If you have some other entry here, so that entry, that is pivotal element, should be made unity, so that is 1. But this is already 1, so we need not do any changes with this particular row. We keep as it is. The other entries must be made 0 in the pivotal column. Already these two entries are 0, so we need not do any changes with this particular row R1 and particular row R2. Only here this entry should be made 0. For that we are doing some row operation. So that is row number 4. Here this is my row number 4. So this entry should be made 0. For that we are making some changes in the row number 4. So that is R3 plus R4 we are making, so that finally that will be made 0 here. So all the other entries are made 0 in the pivotal column. Only the pivotal element is 1 there, right? So that is what we obtained. So now once again you check whether the entries in the objective function row are non-negative. So we don't have any negative entries in the objective function, so we can stop the iteration at this stage, otherwise we have to continue further. Now so we know that some variables entered into the problem and some variables have left the problem. Now we'll have maximum value of z, so that is 47 by 4 at x1 is equal to 5 by 4, and we don't have x2 in the table now. X2 did not enter, so x2 was taken as 0 only. So now x3 is 17 by 4. So now we also see that s1 is equal to 25 by 4. We don't have any changes with s2 and s3. They are left them as 0 only here. So this is the solution of the given problem.